Hello, this is Kathleen Peddicord. I'm the founder and publisher of Live and Invest Overseas. I'm coming to you live today from our office in downtown Panama City, Panama. We are just recently back from Medellin, where we held our first ever Live and Invest in Colombia conference. It was a big success. We had about 75 attendees there, and we spent the week introducing them to Medellin, specifically Colombia generally, but our focus was on Medellin, which is a very special city. Now that we've gotten to know, at least Simon and I, my husband, have gotten to know Colombia a bit, we've realized, in fact, just how special a city Medellin is. And we can't help but draw comparisons, to make comparisons. We travel back and forth frequently now between Medellin and Panama City, where we're based. And every time we come and go, we are struck by the contrasts of these two cities, both very interesting, both with so much to offer, each a 45-minute plane ride from the other, but they couldn't be more different. They are a world apart. The fundamental difference, geographically, of course, is that Panama City is in Central America, Medellin is in South America. Panama is Central America, Colombia is South America, and that may not seem like a big deal, but it is, in fact. Every time you land in Medellin, every time we land at the airport, every time we drive away from the airport and begin the drive down the side of the mountain into the valley where Medellin sits, we're just struck by we're not in Central America anymore. What does that mean? It means the roads are better paved, the infrastructure is more developed, things are cleaner, frankly. There's not the litter problem and the garbage problem that we sometimes have here in Panama City. Once you're in Medellin, the differences are even more striking. Once you're in the city itself, the way people dress, the way they just behave, the way they comport themselves on the streets. Another thing you notice about the streets in Medellin versus Panama City, for example, are the taxis. In both cities, taxis are probably the best way to get around, although Medellin is a far more walkable city than Panama City. But the best way still to get around in both places is by taxi. In Panama City, it's a constant struggle. The taxis aren't metered, the drivers aren't very patient, they aren't very polite, they may not want to take you where you want to go, and in fact sometimes we'll just say, no, I'm not going to take you where you want to go and drive away. In Medellin, it's an entirely different experience that I think is kind of symbolic, or for me it's become almost a metaphor for the city in general. The taxis are metered, the taxi drivers are polite, respectful, helpful. They go out of their way to get you where you want to go, to help you figure out where you want to go. It's an entirely different experience. Now, I don't mean to be negative on Panama City. That's not the point. But this is an important way to approach this. If you're thinking about living, retiring, doing something in another country, and you're considering different places, you need to compare them. Nothing is absolute. Very few things are absolute. Everything is relative. Medellin is relatively cleaner than Panama City. Medellin is relatively calmer, more calm than Panama City. This is an important point. There isn't the traffic, there isn't the constant construction. Panama City is a city working to remake itself before your very eyes, it seems, which can be very frustrating day by day at street level. There's constant construction there. Everything is being torn down and rebuilt there. So there's concrete being poured everywhere and plaster dust everywhere and big construction vehicles in the roads all the time blocking traffic. In Medellin, everything is calmer, quieter. We spent time with friends in Medellin, as we often do, and one there is Panamanian, in fact, and like us, travels back and forth between the two places regularly. He likes to say, every time we return to Medellin, I remember this, and it becomes more true, more real to me, the fundamental reality of this. Medellin is a wonderful place to spend time, whereas Panama is a place to do business. Panama right now is the best place in the world to base yourself for an offshore business, for an international or an internet-based business. Nowhere compares with Panama, certainly not Medellin or Colombia. Panama is a tax haven, which is an important reason why it's a great place to be running a business. Panama is a melting pot, which means that I think of it as the New York City, almost, of Central America. You can find almost any kind of labor you need here, and the labor force is educated, English-speaking, and very affordable. Not so true in Colombia. You aren't going to find English-speaking labor that you need. So Colombia is not a great place to be doing business. It is not a tax haven. In fact, the tax situation in Colombia is not very favorable. It's unfavorable. It's a disadvantage. Whereas in Panama, you can set yourself up to operate, to live, and to operate a business tax-free. It's you're fully compliant, you're not doing anything you shouldn't be doing, but you can pay no taxes, neither you personally nor your business. So let's look, I think, let's kind of bottom line, let's look at these two places. How would we compare them? How would all this shake out? Cost of living, I'd say, is a tie between these two cities, between Medellin and Panama City. Neither is the most affordable place you could think about living or retiring. You could find more affordable options elsewhere in Panama, elsewhere in Colombia, and certainly in other countries. But both are affordable, and more or less your cost of living is going to be the same in both. Cost of real estate, however, here's where there's a dramatic difference, and here's where Medellin, Colombia is a dramatically advantaged choice. Medellin, Colombia is one of the most affordable places in the world right now to buy real estate. And your money goes a long way. What you can buy right now in Medellin is quality of construction, quality of location, quality of lifestyle, quality of finish. All of that is available in Medellin for $1,000 a square meter or less. In Panama right now, for the same location, comparable quality of building, of construction, of apartment, etc., you're going to spend twice that, about $2,000 a square meter. Climate. Again, Medellin comes out way ahead on this front. The climate in Medellin is ideal. It is what many people think of as the perfect weather. Spring like year round. Temperatures in the mid 70s to low 80s all year round. It gets a little bit cooler at night. And if you go into the hills outside Medellin, into slightly higher elevations in the surrounding areas, in fact, many homes come with fireplaces and you'll want a sweater or a jacket at night. It's just perfect. Whereas Panama City, hot and humid all year round. Ease of residency. Panama is probably the winner in this score. Panama offers about a dozen or so very easy, straightforward, user-friendly options for establishing full-time permanent foreign residency if that's something you want to do. There are good options in Colombia as well, but probably not as fully figured out. You'll need a bit more help probably in Colombia to figure out how to establish permanent residency. Ease of banking and doing business. Again, this is where Panama really shines. Panama is no longer a bank secrecy haven, as you probably heard. Panama in 2010 signed an exchange of information treaty with the United States, meaning that there's no such thing anymore as bank secrecy in Panama. I predict there's going to be no such thing as bank secrecy anywhere in the world within not too much more time. It won't be too much longer before every country really is going to knuckle under to pressures from the United States and others. Meantime, this is in fact reality right now in Panama, but that is not the same thing as a banking center. A bank secrecy haven is something other than a banking center. And Panama City is the most developed international banking center in this part of the world, and that is still the reality. It is also a much more developed and a much easier place from a banking point of view than many in Colombia, than anywhere in Colombia, certainly for the foreign resident or the foreign investor. As well, in Colombia, there are exchange controls. This is an important point to keep in mind. There are no currency controls or exchange controls in place in Panama. Another reason why it's such an investor haven and an entrepreneur's haven, why it offers such advantages and opportunity for the investor and the would-be entrepreneur. There are none of these exchange controls or other restrictions or restrictions, on doing business, making money. In Colombia, these things exist. They're not a reason not to invest there, not to own real estate there, not in fact even try to do business there, but there's something you need to know about and you need to plan for and know how to manage. You need an attorney's help, a local Colombian attorney's help to do that. Infrastructure and accessibility, another tie. The infrastructure in both places is developed, real world, from telecommunications to getting around, internet, accessibility, etc. These things are very developed in both places and comparable. Taxes, I mentioned already that while Panama is one of the world's most developed tax havens, Colombia is an expensive place from a tax point of view. Healthcare, top-notch in both places. Medellin, in fact, is home to 5 of the top, I believe, 33 hospitals in all Latin America. And the medical care in Panama City is likewise international standard, very well, very, very fully developed, first world. Ease of settling in. Panama City would win on this score. I think of Panama City as a kind of halfway house for expats. This is a place where it's very easy to settle in. The road is very well paved. You're going to find lots of expats to make friends with. You're going to find that even with minimal Spanish or no Spanish at all, you can get by, you can get through the day. That's not the case in Medellin. In Medellin, language is an important point. You're going to need to learn Spanish to spend any extended time in Medellin, or you're going to be very frustrated trying to get things done, and you're going to feel very lonely because there isn't a very well-developed, at this point, community of expats in Medellin, certainly nothing like you'll find in Panama City. And while many attorneys and business people in Medellin will speak English, the average person on the street does not. Here in Panama City, almost anywhere you go, any retail shop, any store, any bank, anywhere you go to do business, you'll be able to find someone who speaks enough English to help you do what you're trying to do. Again, that's not the case in Medellin. So, where should you think about going? Where should you think about living, retiring, spending money, investing, doing whatever it is you're considering doing? As we say always, it depends on your priorities, your objectives, your agenda, what you're looking for. I've tried to help you compare and contrast and draw out the advantages, the pluses and the minuses of each city. The best case, of course, is if you can organize things so that you can spend time in both. Both of these cities have so much to offer right now. Medellin is just a wonderful place to spend time, and if you haven't been there, I heartily recommend that you ignore what everyone is telling you, that you ignore your friends when they tell you you're crazy to think about going to Medellin, because it's a city run by the drug cartels and one of the most unsafe places in the world. This is not the case. Medellin is, in fact, a very safe place. It's a beautiful, charming city with so much to offer. I strongly recommend if you have any opportunity or any interest, get on a plane and go see. That's, in fact, the only way to make a decision about any of these places, any place you might be considering, from Panama City to Medellin and anywhere beyond on the world map. Get on a plane and go see for yourself. I'll be back again soon. This is Kathleen Peddicord with Live and Invest Overseas. Our website is liveandinvestoverseas.com, and we write about these ideas about places like Medellin and Panama City and opportunities all around the world every day in our free e-letter. If you aren't getting it already, please go now, take a minute, liveandinvestoverseas.com, and sign up. It's free. I'll be in touch again soon.